Friends, welcome to my channel Qlik to Express, and today we'll be discussing on some basic functions used in QlikSense. So let's see what are those. So the basic functions which I'm using over here are very important when you're designing any data model, and also it is very important when you're doing any front-end modification. Basically, we try to do these changes, or as a good programmer we'll try to do these changes in the backend, and so as to increase the performance of the application. So the function used over here can be written in both backend and frontend. So let's see few functions. The first one is string concatenation. So how it is done? Suppose I want a column where employee ID gives me employee ID hyphen and my employee name. So what I can do is I can simply write. You can write it anywhere. In this whether in the end or in the front. So I am writing here in the middle. So this is a concatenation string function, ampersand and operator. So I'll just give a space and a hyphen, and then I want to print the employee name, and then I want to rename it as employee ID name, and then put a comma. So if I reload it now, okay, I forgot to give a ampersand sign. So what it's gonna do is it will take this, will concatenate this string versus this string, and finally the column name will come as ID name. So let's see. So if I move to the front end, take a filter pane, and I'll just take the dimension employee ID name. So it is giving you the same thing that can be written in the front end as well. So how we can write it, I'm just copying the same thing. So since I have both the fields present in my back end, so obviously I can go here, and instead of taking this dimension, I can add a new dimension, go to the expression and write the same thing, and it's gonna give me the same expression. Obviously you can go here and change the title, like, and it's gonna give me the same thing. So similarly, I'll be doing few functions in the front end and few functions in the back end, so as to, you know, make you aware that the functions can be written in back end and front end both. So now I'm using, the next function is your length function. So length gives you the number of character present in that string, and it also includes your space. So let's now take a text box, and there I'll be writing this function, len function. So is equals to, first of all, then len, and suppose I want to write Qlik to express express. So what it gonna do is it gonna print 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 and 14. So two space also are included. So you can see it is printing me 14. What happened? Fine. So if you check here, it is printing me 14. Okay. So now let's move to the next one. Next one is left. So what left gives you, the number of characters from the left hand side, and you can specify the number of characters you want from your left hand side. So specifically, if I go here, and I use the same thing, and I'll just write here as left, and suppose I want to print 4 characters, so I'll just give 4 over here, and then apply. So it's gonna give me the 4 letters from the front end, from the left hand side. Similarly, right will give me letters from my right hand side. So if I write here right, it's gonna give me last 4 letters, 1 2 3 4. So it's gonna give me the last 4 letters. So next one is your numeric function. So numeric function, what it does is just give you a round off value, or you can say in a simpler language. So what it does, there are 3 types of numeric functions. One is seal. So what seal does is it rounds up the parameter to a specified indicated multiple to the upper hand side. How? I'll just tell you. So if I create a small table over here for seal, floor and round. Suppose I create a table here for seal, floor and round, and I'll write a very easy way of explanation. 9.1, 9.5 and then 9.9. So the seal of 9.1 will give you 10, 9.5 also will give you 10, whereas 9.9 also will give you 10. So seal is nothing but top, so it will upgrade the number to the topmost value. So even if you have a value less than 9.5, it will upgrade it to 10. Whereas floor just does the opposite thing. So it will reduce it to 9. This also will be reduced to 9. And this also will be reduced to 9. Whereas round will follow your mathematical formulas. So 9.1 will give you 9. 9.5 will give you 10. Whereas 9.9 will give you 10. So this is how your seal and floor works. Seal, floor and round works. So let's see how it can be written in the front end. So for example, if I go here, simple, I'll just write here CEIL seal of 9.5 should give me 10. So it gives you 10. So this is how you write it for seal, floor and round. So now let's move to upper. So what upper does is it converts the entire string into uppercase. So for example, if I go here, write a upper over here, and I give a thing as click to. Okay, so you will see it will change everything to upper characters. Now lower will do the opposite thing. It will change this to lower order. So I can do it in the front end or back end, no matter what. So you can see everything got changed to lower. Capitalize will change it to camel form. That means every first character of a word will be changed to capital. For example, if I go here, change it to CAP, capitalize, it will convert each letter. So if it will change each letter, each of the first letter of each word to capital. Okay, the next one is your mid and mid function. So very carefully listen, these functions are very important. Mid function, what it does, suppose in a string, suppose you have a string or you have a word, and suppose maybe it is like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. You know now how to print from the left hand side using left function. You know how to print it from the right hand side using right function. Suppose you want to print it from certain place in from the center. So how you can do it? You can use mid function. So how mid function is used? Suppose I want to use a mid function over here. Mid. Suppose I want to start from the fifth letter. So my fifth letter is nothing but, or let's take it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to start from E and print 3 letters. So it should print me EXP. So what I want to do is, I want to start it from the 8th letter. So my 8th letter will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So my 8th letter will be E, and I want to print 3 letters. So if I write apply, so you can see it will give me EXP. So what it does is, starting, this gives you the start from where you want to start, the position and the number of letters you want to present. Okay, the next one is your index. So what index does is, it will give you the position, and you can obviously specify its occurrence. So the definition is tough, but the thing is very easy. For example, so let's take index over here. So what index does is, it gives you the position of the letter or the string you want to present. So suppose I want to see the position of S. Okay, so I can mention here the position of S. So now by default it will give you the position of the first S. Okay, so if I write it over, if I give an apply, so it is showing me 13. So if you calculate over here, value as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So it is giving me the position of the first S. Okay, but I can, there is one more S, that is the second value. So I can specify the position of which S I want. So I can give it as 2. So I want the position of S, but the second S I want to show. So it should give me 14. So it is giving me 14. So combination of mid and index are very important and is widely used. Okay, so next one is your replace. So what replace does is, it changes or it modifies a particular word. Okay, so it a particular string, you can say. So it also includes your entire string, and you can probably give a particular word which has to be replaced. For example, if I go here, take it as replace, and I want to replace 2, okay, and I want to replace it with TO2. Okay, so it's gonna search in the entire string, wherever 2 is written, it will replace with 2. So if you see, it will replace it to 2. So if there are some other places also, like if I have a underscore 2 over here, so it will replace this 2 also. So if you see, this also got replaced to 2. Okay, so it will search the entire string and replace the value. Okay, so the next one is your keep char. So what keep char does is, it will keep the particular value. For example, if I give the if I take this value click to express, and if I keep press, so it will keep the press value and remove the rest of the thing. So it checks letter by letter. Okay, so how, let me show you. Suppose I keep here keep char. So if I give a keep char and I want to keep the character that is nothing but S, so it will search the entire string, wherever there is S, it will keep it as it is. So I have 2S, so ideally it should give me output as 2S, because there are 2S which has to be kept, because I have asked it to keep S. So if you see here, it will give me 2S because there are 2S in the string. So suppose I want to give as press, so it will check the entire value from here. I don't have any other P, so it will keep this P, it will keep R, and I can, if I remove S also, it will check for, like, it is checking letter by letter. Okay, so if I use P, so it will check the entire string. If I have underscore PPPP, so suppose I have 4 P's here, so it should keep not only this P but also these P's also. Okay, so let's check, see here. So what it has done, it has kept all the letter and also those P's. So what it is doing, it is checking one letter with the entire string and keeping all the letters which is present in that string. Okay, it is not only seeing it press, so it is present over here press, and it is not giving that value. It is checking each letter one by one, the entire string, and wherever these numbers are repeated, these letters are repeated, it is giving you those values. Okay, so now let's move to the next one. The next one is your purge char. It is very similar, or it's just an opposite, not similar, it is just an opposite to keep char. So it will remove those characters. Suppose if I write PUR purge char, so it will remove PRE and 2S over here. So you will see that thing got removed. Okay, so it also checks letter by letter. Okay, whereas replace checks entire word. Okay, so be very careful in that. Now suppose there is a string where generally you will find it when you are loading it from a text file. Suppose you have a string, say it like name slash doj slash, and then you have salary. So you want to print only doj. So what you can do is you can write tex text between. So from text between you can identify which word you want to print. So suppose I want to print the word which comes after the slash and which ends after the slash, and if I print it like this, it will give me DOJ. But suppose I have one more value over here, say it like a bonus. Okay, suppose I have a value. So now it becomes a confusion for Qlik to start from which slash and into which slash. Basically there are two pairs, right? This is the first pair, and then if you say this is the second pair, so you can mention which pair of data you want to show. So if I write comma 2, so it will ignore the first pair, that means the DOJ, then it will consider the second pair. So now this thing will print me the salary. Okay, so what it is basically doing, it takes up the value from this from the first character and till the second character you give, and it should give me the pair of it, the so the second pair it will print for me. Okay, so be very careful, try using different kind of symbols and doing it. Okay, so next one is your subfield. Subfield also is pretty much same as text between. So if I use a subfield over here, you will see you don't have to mention this character, so it's very easy and very important. So if I use a subfield function over here, so now if you see, it will give me DOJ, because subfield will take the value, subfield will take the value of the second character, oh I'm sorry, I didn't mention the symbol by which it should separate. So it will separate the value with the second character. It should ideally give me salary. Let's see. It should ideally give me DOJ, because the second character is this. It is separating the value based on your slash. Okay. So very sorry. So that is what you should be very careful when you are, you know, writing this function. If I write 3 over here, it will give me salary. So you will see it is giving me salary. Okay, so these are the very basic functions, and combination of these functions are very useful when you are creating the data model. So thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.